Hi, my name is Sergey Botenko. I'm an engineer in CleanMyMac, and here is our new episode of AtMain News, the news about iOS and macOS development. Apple has finally released API for the Dynamic Island, so I want to share with you some highlights. First of all, the Dynamic Island is directly connected with a live activity. Namely, it shows this activity, not some information. Secondly, the Dynamic Island has three different presentations: compact, minimal, and expanded. I will tell you about each one in detail. If only one live activity is active, then the compact presentation is used. It is composed of two elements to the left and right of the Dynamic Island. And you can also tap it to open the corresponding app. If more than one live activity is active, then the minimal presentation is used. The system chooses one live activity to appear attached to the Dynamic Island, while the other appears detached. So two activities are displayed for two different apps. And both of them look like circles. And if you make a long press on the Dynamic Island, then the expanded presentation will open. It looks like a container that takes the entire width of a device and can be up to 160 points in height. And it has strictly defined sections where you can add your content. And there is one surprising moment. If a device doesn't have a Dynamic Island, users will get the partial support. When the live activity state is updated, such devices will display an expanded presentation as a banner on top. And finally, Apple gives a bunch of tips on how to work better with live activities and the Dynamic Island. For example, the UI of compact and expanded presentations should be consistent. So when you open the expanded presentation, it should look like a real expanding, not showing different UI. Also, it is recommended not to display ads. It's a bit funny because they use the phrase avoid using instead of don't use, so it's kinda allowed. More tips can be found on the Human Interface Guideline page and the link below. Life hacks from Twitter. The first life hack is that the package file for SPM is just Swift code. And it means that you can create variables there. For example, if a lot of targets have the same dependency, it can be described once in a variable and pass a parameter to the configuration. The second life hack is that you can add a special key to your infop list. And then App Store Connect won't ask you if you use any encryption when you submit an update. And the last life hack is related to the new IfGuard shorthand. Here is a regex that allows you to find all the old expressions in your project and replace them with the new ones. Praemonitus, praemunitus, or forewarned, forearmed. Every year, October is dedicated to cybersecurity awareness. During this month, people create and share content that is focused on teaching people to be more secure on the internet. For example, the director of cybersecurity at the NSA made a meme on this topic. He's choosing between creating a meme or creating a security guide. As you can see, he has made his choice. And I, in turn, want to give you some practical tips. They are quite basic, so you shouldn't neglect them. First, check potential leaks of your password on third-party services. You can do it on haveibeenpwned.com website. This site checks if your email has been seen in any databases that have been stolen. For each case, there will be detailed information when it happened and what exactly was stolen. And it can be both passwords and your personal data. Second, check if you have set up two-factor authentication. It is better to use application as a second factor instead of SMS. It can be Google Authenticator, Authy, or something of your choice. Third, do not click on suspicious links and do not use public Wi-Fi networks without an extra need. Such sites or networks can breach your privacy. And if you're interested in security, especially on the iOS and macOS platforms, then you must know the Objective-C website. Patrick Wardle, the author of the website, has written a book about malware, created a bunch of tools on the topic, and host a security conference called Objective by the Sea. Name is simply amazing. All recordings are available on their YouTube channel. Apple Developer Center has updated the interface. The last redesign was in 2016 and looked like this. A sidebar and several tiles that actually duplicate the sidebar items. Now the Developer Center looks like this. The sidebar with general items has been replaced with sections. Under each section we have links to specific pages, which is quite convenient. But only the main page was redesigned. All other pages have the old interface. I hope you enjoyed the news. Please share any feedback or ideas on the episode in the comments below. See ya!